Hi guys, my name's Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine, and you were just listening to the sounds of the Seymour Duncan Fooz, which is an analog fuzz synthesizer. You might think about this as essentially a fuzz bootstrapped to the filter section from an analog synth. Now, don't switch off just yet. I'm going to show you what all that means in guitarist-friendly terms, but those of you who are synth savvy will already be salivating at the prospect of the tones you can conjure from this lovely little box. Now, quick word on the gear we're using. Of course, I'm playing my Paul Reed Smith EG4. Two single coils, Duncan 59 in the bridge. We are playing through a Jet City Amelia set clean. Sounds like this. And if we kick off just by listening to the fuzz, I'm gonna knock it on over here. It's gonna sound like this. So as you can hear, it's a pretty warm and organic sounding fuzz. It's not terribly obnoxious or hairy, but as we turn the gain up, we can start to get some serious noise going on. Sounds like this. And of course over here we have a TC flashback providing just a little bit of splash. Sounds like this. So it's a load of really fast slaps, sounds kind of robotic and mechanical. Let's have a little bit of a look at the features on this wee pedal down here. Starting again with the fuzz section, we have a switch down here which turns the tremolo on and off. Now the trem is synced to the tap tempo over here. Sounds like this. And that's really only the beginning of the fun. We're gonna start over here by having a little bit of a look at the synth section. Now, there are two parts to this. There is essentially the filter part and the LFO, which we're gonna have a look at up there in a second, and I'll explain all this stuff as we go on. Let's start by looking at filter, though, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna knock it up here to the setting that says envelope. Now, what this essentially does is this ties the input signal of your guitar to the filter cutoff which is over down there, the cutoff frequency. Now, if, very, very quickly, if I fiddle with that sensitivity knob, I'm gonna put this up here where it says BPF, stands for bandpass filter. It's gonna sound something like this. If we turn these controls up, we're going to get a more exaggerated effect, especially the resonance. And in here, that's essentially operating like an auto wah, you might think of it as, but the difference is that the auto wah is being applied after the fuzz, but it's being triggered before the fuzz, so it's really sensitive to your pick dynamics. Now, I understand we're sort of skimming over the inner workings of this. If you understand what all this stuff means, you don't need me to explain it to you. If you're a guitar player who has no idea, I'm gonna try and keep it simple for you. So, very, very quickly, bandpass filter versus low pass filter. What this means, it's essentially going to allow all of the low frequencies below a certain point through and get rid of all the high frequencies above that point. And again, we're tied to our envelope. So what this is going to do is it's going to allow us to essentially, based on how hard we hit, we're going to get more high frequencies coming through. Sounds like this. If that's a little too drastic, we can turn the resonance control down and get some really quite smooth filtering. It's going to sound like this. But that's not all. We can also switch this across. So rather than being tied to the envelope, it's tied to what's called an LFO, which stands for low frequency oscillator. And that is essentially a waveform that triggers these filters that we've had down here. So if, for argument's sake, we start with everything set at 12, we're gonna get this kind of sound. And this again is tied to the tap tempo, which is very cool. Let's just go back to 12 o'clock on these two, and we'll keep it on bandpass filter for now. We're gonna get this kind of sound. Now, a quick note on the depth and speed. If you've used any modulation pedal before, these will be fairly self-explanatory to you. But remember, these are referring to the depth and speed of the low frequency oscillator. So it's basically how much kind of manipulation of these two controls is going on. So if we kind of leave that somewhere in the middle, let's play with the wave for a moment. If we go over this way, we get a very smooth sine wave. But very interestingly, if we go over this way, we get a really choppy sounding square wave. It gives us this kind of thing. And if we combine that with a tremolo, we're gonna get this sort of vibe. Now, keeping that sort of vibe going, if we back the depth down a little bit and we turn the gain back, we can get something a bit like this. If we tap the speed out, let's just slow that down a little. We might get something like this. Thank you. which is very cool. So there's all sorts of interesting kind of wobble noises that you can get going on here, but there's some other stuff you can do too, using the matrix of dip switches on the back that we'll show you in just a second. Essentially what these do is allow you to determine how the envelope, first of all, interacts with the LFO. So if we set it this way, we can allow the envelope to essentially determine the depth or the speed or both controls on the LFO. Let's see how that sounds. So you can hear there, the volume I'm hitting my guitar with is determining how deep the modulation is on the LFO. Let's switch it around, and this time let's control the speed with the volume. And as if that wasn't enough, there's another dip switch which inverts the way that the envelope works. So instead of getting faster in this instance as you hit harder, it'll get slower. Let's try that. And that's before we connect an expression pedal to this jack back here, which allows you to control a whole myriad of parameters on here. And the dip switches essentially control what the expression pedal is talking to. Now, we're not going to get into that today because we could be here for the rest of our lives. There are so many possibilities with this pedal. It's really exciting. It's a great sounding bit of kit, but it's also full of interesting noises that you wouldn't expect to find out of a guitar. So if you're a songwriter or you're a guitar player in a band who's perhaps looking for new noises or wants to go in new musical directions, this is a great pedal to sort of lead you down those kind of roads. Or if, like some of our staff here at GI, you're into electronic music or you're into drum and bass, as some of our guys are, you can try and recreate some of that stuff with your guitar or your bass using a pedal like this. So in a nutshell, that's a very brief overview of the Seymour Duncan Fooz pedal. We couldn't possibly hope to go into all the options you can get from a pedal like this in a review like this, but hopefully at least you've got a bit of a look at what it does and how it sounds. I'm really impressed. I think it's a dead exciting pedal. Looking forward to having a little bit of a play with this one off camera as well. So anyway, I'm going to leave that there for the time being. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. I'll see you next time.